Welcome to Learning Math Skills with another lecture. This is the fifth lecture of your topic Angles in Geometrical Figures. So as we solved different questions in the previous lecture with the help of properties which we learned in the first three lectures. So in the previous lecture we will solve some questions from your textbook. Now I draw some questions from your textbook. In the previous question we solved from your workbook. So I hope you practice the previous questions and you know the properties and the of angles and the different geometrical shapes and the angles in these geometrical basic shapes like triangles, like parallelogram, like rhombus or like square and a rectangle. So let's start. So I draw some questions from your textbook. First we will solve these questions and we will take the help from your textbook as well for reading the questions. So the first question is that ABCD is a square. What is ABCD is a square and BECF is a rhombus. Okay, and you have to find the unknown angle, that is DCF. What is DCF? This angle is unknown, we have to find. So now what are the properties of rhombus? That is, opposite angles are same, means if this is 64 then this angle is also 64. What angle is this one? That is BFC, means angle BFC, that is also is 64 degree. Why it is 64 degree? Because opposite angles of rhombus is equal. So now what does these two lines shows? These two lines shows that these two angles are same. These two angles are same and but unknown angles. So how can you find these unknown angles? You know BFC is a triangle. Just it is a triangle now, na? Just consider this triangle. So what will we do? As we did in the previous lecture, the sum of angles of a triangle is 180. So it's very easy for you, these two unknown angles we name it, let's see, that is angle A, that is also angle A. So what will you do? You will simply make an equation, angle A plus angle A plus 64, that is equal to 180 degree. We will subtract 2a is equal to 180 degree minus 64 degree. What we get? We will get 116, right? That is equal to 2a. Now we have to divide 116 into two equal parts. So for that purpose we will divide it by 2. So angle A is equal to 116 divided by 2, we will get our answer, that is 58 degree. Means these two angles are of 58 degree each. Means this angle is 58 degree. As I written the question that A, B, C, D is a square. So square means each angle of a square is right angle, means this is a right angle, and out of that right angle this angle is 58. So what will be your unknown angles? Simply we have to subtract 58 from 90 because it is a complementary sum of two angles is equal to 90 degree. So angle DCF, angle DCF, that is equal to 90 degree minus 58 degree, and that is your answer is 32 degree. That is your required answer, right? Okay, now come to this question. So what is written in this question? We will see in the book. In this question, ABCD is a trapezium, okay? That means A, B, C, D is trapezium. Is that in trapezium we have only one pair of parallel lines, and ACD is a equilateral triangle, means this is your equilateral triangle, right? So what will we do? Equilateral triangle, what is the property of equilateral triangle? Equilateral triangle means all sides and angles are equal, and sum of angles are equal to 180. So what will be the each angle? Each angle is of 60 degree. So first we will write it, because we know it that angle of an equilateral triangle always is equal to 60 degree. Now we have to find the angle ACB. So our unknown angle is this one, right? So as you know, these two are the parallel lines, and the angles between two parallel lines, the sum of angles is always is equal to 180 degree. What does it mean? Just understand by this simple example. This is a parallel line and there is a line. The sum of these two angles always is equal to 180. The similar condition is here, that these two are the parallel lines and this is a transversal. So sum of these two angles is equal to 180 degree. And what is this complete angle? That is DCB. That is DCB. So how can you find angle DCB? How can you find? Similar, simply we will subtract 35 from 180. 180 minus 35, we will get answer that is 145 degree. Means this whole angle is 145 degree, right? But we have to find only ACB. We have to find only ACB. We find this angle, that is 60 degree. So how can you find angle ACB? What is total angle? That is 145. And what is this angle? That is 60. So we will subtract 60 from 145 and we will get our remaining answer, that is ACB, that is required angle. So subtract, what will be your answer? That is 75? 5? No, it's 85. 85 degree. So clear? Understand? Okay, now come to this shape. What kind of shape is this one? So for this detail, we will take help from your book. ABC is an isosceles triangle. Means this is your isosceles triangle. These two sides are equal. It means this angle will be equal to this angle. Clear? This is your 41 angle. So what will be this angle? This angle is also 41 degree. So now move forward. BCD is a parallelogram. Then it means this BCDE, that is a parallelogram. So what is the property of parallelograms? In parallelograms, the opposite angles are equal. Opposite angles are equal means this angle is equal to this one, right? And the other property is that the sum of these two angles must be equal to 180. So this is your 38, right? So what will be DCB angle? I write here angle DCB. So we will subtract 38 from 180. 180 is very important. Mostly questions we are subtracting from 180. Sum of this thing is 180, sum of these angles are 180. So keep this thing in your mind. So we will subtract 38 from 180. We will get, what will be your answer? I think you know the subtraction, that is 142. So your angle C is 142, right? So we have to find the X. Unknown is angle X. We find this angle, that is 142. So now we will find this angle. How can you find this angle? We have these two angles, that is 41 and 41 each. What will be the sum of triangle angles? That is 180 degree. So we name this angle, that is ACB. So angle ACB is equal to 180 minus 41 plus 41. What we get? We get 82. So by subtracting 82 from 180, we will get our answer, that is 88. No, that is 98. Am I right? Okay. So we will get this answer, that is 98 degree. So you know what is the total angle at a one point? That is 360. So little change in the question. Now we have to subtract from 360. sum of angles at any point is equal to 360 degree. So it means two angles we known, that this angle is 142, this angle is 98. So we will add these two and we will subtract from 360 sum of the angles. So angle X is equal to 360 degree minus 98 degree minus 142 degree. So you can calculate it very easily. You can subtract this. This is the easy calculations. So now come to the next question. Again, we will take help from your book. What questions are this? ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, this is your parallelogram. These two sides are opposite sides are parallel, right? This side is parallel to this one. And ECF is an isosceles triangle, and ADF is angle given to you, that is 36. Find AEB. We have to find the angle AEB. This angle we have to find. Okay, so now ADF, this triangle is also isosceles triangle, means these two sides are equal. So it means these two angles are also equal. This angle is 36. So what will be this angle? This angle is also 36. Okay, by considering ADF is an isosceles triangle, that condition is given to you. So now come to this triangle. This triangle is ECF, that is also an isosceles triangle, means these two sides are same. It means these two angles are same. So if this is 36, this what will be this angle? This angle is also 36. So now you can find this angle very easily by subtracting these two angles from 180. And what is this angle? That is CEF. So how can you find angle CEF? 180 minus 36 minus 36 means 180 degree minus 72 degree, right? So you can subtract it. What will be your answer? That is 108 degree, means this angle is 108 degree. So you know the vertical opposite angles are equal, means if we have like this, this angle will be equal to this one. So if you look here, these are vertical opposite angles, means angle we have to find, this is your unknown angle, that is AEB. So AEB, that is also equal to 108 degree, because they are vertical opposite. So required angle is AEB, that is equal to 180 degree vertical opposite angle. So you can write here, right? So now come to the last question. What is the last question? We see from, again taking help from book, because if you read all the questions, then boards are very filled and very little space to solve the questions. ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, ABCD is a parallelogram, opposite sides are parallel. Okay, fine. And ABEF is a rhombus. ABEF is a rhombus. Okay, fine. Two angles are given and you have to find the unknown angles, that is X and Y. Okay, now this is parallelogram and rhombus, and you know the properties of parallelogram is very easily now, that the opposite sides are parallel, so opposite angles are equal, and sum of angles on the same side, that is equal to, that is equal to 180. Okay, now A, if you look at the triangle ABE, this is parallelogram, rhombus, means four sides are equal. These two sides are equal. Now we are discussing only this triangle AEB. These two sides are same, so it means this angle is equal to the this angle. But both angles are unknown. So what can you do? Simply we will subtract 62 from 180 and divide the rest of the answer by 2, as we did in this question. You solve these questions by making this equation, or by simply dividing minus 62 from 180. Why from 180? Because sum of triangles is equal to 180. So we will use the same method as we use in this question. I name it angle B. Okay, so what will be your equation? I draw a line from separate solution. So what will be your equation? B plus B plus 62, that is equal to 180 degree. So 2b is equal to, now when we move 62 it will subtract, so by subtracting 180 we will get our answer, that is 118 degree, right? So by dividing 2 on the both sides, what we get our answer, 118 divided by 2, our answer is 59 degree, means angle B is equal to 59 degree. So now just considering that is a straight line, okay, and there are two angles making on a straight line. So now you can find your unknown angle X, how? By subtracting 59 from 180, means angle X is equal to 180 degree minus 59. So what will be your answer? Your answer is 121 degree, means X is equal to 121 degree. Okay, now ABCD is a parallelogram, this is parallelogram, okay, and this is a transversal, right? As I explained you earlier, the sum of angles on the same sides between a parallel lines are 180. So it means the sum of these two angles must be equal to 180. So we will again subtract 121 from 180 for finding the angle Y, that is again 180 minus 121. So again we will get the same answer, not the same answer, that is 59, as previous we will subtract 59, so we will get 121. So I hope you understand today's questions, little bit tricky, but if you have the properties of angles of these shapes in your mind, then it will be a very interesting and very easy chapter. So I hope you understand. So do practice these questions from your textbook, do practice the questions from your workbook. If you practice these questions, then you will do it very easily. Without practice, it's very hard to learn these questions. Of any question in mathematics, practice is a very important for any students to making good grades. So stay tuned till next lecture. Inshallah, next lecture we will do some more questions from your textbook and from your workbook, from the related topic, and we will wind up the topic. So share, subscribe and like my channel, that is Learning Math Skills with Kashif.